all for coming. Yes, I did need everyone here to make a small announcement. Yes, but before I begin, would anyone be interested in some wine? It is in Greek. Does anyone read Greek? No. I'm sorry. Why do I have it? I am not the only one who used to stalk this bar. Yes. No, Greek is a language with an alphabet that I am not familiar with. Yes. Would anyone like wine? Greek wine of unknown origin. You will. I thought you might. How much would you like? None. You can have one. One glass to start. Yes. Well, I do have news. Please be responsible with this. Yes. Yes, forgive me. I do have news. I thought that the wine may help. It is not entirely bad news. No, there is a negative component and a positive component. The positive news is that Mr. Harker is not a suspect in the murder of Felix. Well, I suppose it may not be positive for all of you. However, I think it is positive to rule someone out. Yes, definitively. No, it appears that Felix was not physically capable of committing a crime such as that, and he did have a solid alibi, as you helped discover. Yes. Yes, I do understand that that means that the rest of us are suspects. However, well, I thought that it was somewhat positive. You don't want to know what the bad news is, if that was positive. Right. Yes, you know, that is a great question. Where is Mr. Harker? Indeed. That brings me to my next point. Mr. Harker is... how should I say this? Mr. Harker is... deceased. No, I am not joking. What a horrible thing to joke about. Yes, I am indeed serious. No, Mr. Harker is indeed deceased. I do not believe that it was murder. No. However, it is a possibility. Of course. And since we still are without any electricity, any way to contact the outside world, unless somebody is brave enough to attempt to ski out of here, which I do not recommend. Bartholomew. No. No. Goodness. No, I do not suspect that Mr. Harker's death was anything nefarious. He was not very good physical shape. However, it is of course possible that something dastardly did take place and that one of us is responsible. No, no. So, after everyone has finished their Greek wine or their meals or whatever they have left, I would request that all of us please retire to our rooms and stay there until morning. Yes. I do believe it would be the safest option, as I do not want more people to pass on. This retreat has turned into something of a disaster. And I do not want my chalet associated with any more death, if possible. everyone please lock your doors and stay in your rooms until morning. Right, thank you, and please stay safe. Thank you for meeting me here. I know it is a little cold and unpleasant. Yes, I didn't want anyone else to know. I was hoping the other two would stay in their rooms. Yes. Now, I asked you here for a reason, not a nefarious reason. True, I suppose I wouldn't tell you if it was. It might be wise to have a small discussion about any, yes, considering the new event. Right, I did have a chance to speak with, yes, this is where I have been keeping Felix's body. I did put Mr. Harker, perhaps it's best you don't take a good look. Yes, well, it is a little chilly here, so it seemed appropriate. They weren't particularly large people, I wasn't really that difficult, no. Anyhow, I did have a conversation with Mademoiselle Lalaurie, and it was not particularly useful. No, however, I did discover the source of the sound that Bartholomew was talking about. Yes, remember the strange animalistic cry? Yes. During my discussion with Mademoiselle Lalaurie, we discussed her alibi, so to speak, which admittedly was rather flimsy. However, she did tell me that she was very interested in impressing Bartholomew. Yes, she said that she is, what was the word she used? She has a particular affinity for him. Yes, and because he is Italian, she assumed that he must like opera. And she was practicing opera in her room in an attempt to, I suppose, attract him. Yes. Now, Mademoiselle Lalaurie is not a talented singer. I do believe that was the source of the sound. Yes. Yes, so I don't believe that's something that we need to worry about. Correct. Now that does give her and Bartholomew an alibi for that specific time. Yes, it does complicate things. However, it was brief. Yes, and we do not know for certain if it was the exact time of the murder of Felix. Now, both of them, yes, both of them should stay on the suspect list as well. Did you learn any information? Oh, certainly, certainly, yes, you have questions about Mr. Harker. I'm not entirely certain what occurred. Now, my first assumption was that it was an accident. It was quite recently I discovered him at the bottom of the stairwell. Naturally, that is what I assumed. He must have fallen because he lives his life in a weakened state. The elevator certainly is not running with no electricity. However, upon closer inspection, it appeared as though he may have fallen as a result of something else. No, I do not believe his fall was a direct result of his weak constitution. I do think something else happened. Well, if you look, perhaps you may not want to look too closely. I was a little bit nervous when it came to touching him, because I do not know what happened. However, it is my assumption that he may or may not have been poisoned. Yes. Well, if you see around, no, if you look to the side of his, yes, that does not appear completely natural to me, nor does it appear to be the result of a very long tumble down a flight of stairs. I also thought that if he did tumble down the stairs while he was still alive, surely someone would have heard him cry out for help, because although he is, or was, I suppose now, although he was a particularly weak man, his lungs appeared to be functioning, and so did his voice. Indeed, he was rather vocal when he required assistance, so it is my belief that he would have shouted or screamed or otherwise expressed himself in some way. I do believe that he must have passed away, or begun the process of passing away, unfortunately, that close to the stairwell, and then tumbled down. I'm not certain who. My problem here is that Felix was lovely, and I cannot imagine a reason anyone would have for wanting to harm him. Mr. Harker, however, appeared to be, well, not everyone's favorite guest. Yes, if you want to, there is some sort of covering. Just toss it. Yes. I do apologize for that. It is somewhat morbid, I recognize. However, this area does afford us some privacy to have a discussion. As I was saying, I believe that everyone has a motive in regards to Mr. Harker's passing. Yes. So I do believe this will be slightly more difficult than anticipated. No one had a motive for Felix. Everyone has a motive for Mr. Harker. It is a strange situation to be in. Yes. Now, I would like to make a request that there is no breaking into any rooms tonight. Yes. As much as I am enjoying collaborating on this, you are certainly still a suspect. Of course, I hope that you are not the guilty one. I have really been enjoying this. However, I have to be smart about this. Yes. I would request that you stay in your room. Tomorrow morning, everyone should be meeting for breakfast, provided everyone is still alive. Goodness gracious. We can have a discussion, and perhaps we will find something. I am hoping that after breakfast, let's occupy them with some sort of activity. And we can go upstairs and search. Yes. We can search for things and then have a rendezvous with our findings. Do you have any concerns? Yes, I suppose that is a valid concern, and I'm sure we all share the same fear that we may be next. However, it appears that the snow has stopped falling, so it is my hope that soon we will have electricity again. Yes, and we may. Are you comfortable with that plan of action? Good, good. Then I will see you tomorrow morning.